ஆண்டாள் திருவடிகளே சரணம். திருப்பாவை 18th பாசுரம். உந்துவத கலிற்றன் ஓடாத தொல்வழியன் நந்த கோபாலன் மருமகளே நப்பின்னாய் கந்தம் கமழும் குழலி கடை திறவாய் வந்து எங்கும் கோழி அழைத்தன கான் மாதவி பந்தல் மேல் பல்கால் குயிலி நங்கள் கூவின கான் பந்தார் விரலி உண்மை துணன் பேர் பாட செந்தாமரை கையால் சீரார் வளையொழிப்ப வந்து திறவாய் மகிழ்ந்தேலோரெம்பாவாய். ஆண்டாள் அண்ட் ஹர் ஃப்ரெண்ட்ஸ் ஹாவ் ரீச்ட் கிருஷ்ணாஸ் பேலஸ் அண்ட் தே ஆர் ட்ரைங் டு அவேக்கன் பீப்புள் ப்ரெசன்ட் இன் கிருஷ்ணாஸ் பேலஸ். தே ஹாவ் சக்சஸ்ஃபுல்லி woken up Nandagopa, Yashoda and Balarama in the 17th Pasuram. In today's Pasuram, the 18th Pasuram, Andal and her friends are going to wake a very, very important person up. Who is this important person? This person is known as Nappinnai and she is Krishna's cousin. Yashoda had a brother named Kumbha and Kumbha's daughter was Nappinnai. She was born a couple of years after Krishna and so was named Pinnai, it seems. Pinnai means the one who was born after, and Nappinnai is the one who was born after for a good cause. For which good cause was this Nappinnai born? She was born to serve Krishna. She was born to become his consort, and that is what exactly happened. Nappinnai became Krishna's consort and Kumbha decided to give his daughter in marriage to Krishna, and so right from childhood Nappinnai and Krishna grew up together in Yashoda's house itself. So Nappinnai is hailed as the favorite consort of Krishna by the Alvars. And Andal follows suit and sings about Nappinnai and her glory in this pasuram. She wants to wake up Nappinnai so that Nappinnai would join them and come and help them to wake up Krishna and also abide to their prayers and yield fruits to them. So she's calling out to Nappinnai in this pasuram as நந்தகோபாலன் மருமகளே நப்பின்னாய். ஷி சேஸ், ஓ நப்பின்னை, த டாட்டர் இன் லா ஆஃப் நந்தகோபாலா. நப்பின்னை லைக்ஸ் டு பி கால்ட் அஸ் த டாட்டர் இன் லா ஆஃப் நந்தகோபாலா, இட் சீம்ஸ், பிகாஸ் நப்பின்னை இஸ் த கான்சர்ட் ஆஃப் கிருஷ்ணா. கிருஷ்ணா இஸ் லார்ட் விஷ்ணு ஹிம்செல்ஃப், ஸோ ஹிஸ் கான்சர்ட் நப்பின்னை இஸ் அண்ட் இன்கார்னேஷன் ஆஃப் லக்ஷ்மி தேவி. And Lakshmi Devi likes to address herself as the daughter-in-law of somebody, of her father-in-law. She has said this when she incarnated as Sita. Whenever anybody asked Sita who she was, she would say, Snusha Dasharathasyaham. I am the daughter-in-law of Dasharatha. That is how she would introduce herself. That was the first identity she gave about herself. So she was very fond of being called as her father-in-law's daughter-in-law, because she was cared for by the father-in-law like that, and she respected her father-in-law and his clan like that. And that is how a cultured girl must be. So Lakshmi Devi is showing us that path, and Andal has well understood this path, and she knows how Lakshmi Devi or Nappinnai likes to be called. And so she addresses her as Nandagopalan Marumagale Nappinnai. Marumagal means daughter-in-law. Now she gives an adjective to this Nandagopa. How is this Nandagopa? Andal ensures that every time she talks about Nandagopa, she gives an adjective to him. She had given an adjective of Kurvel Kodundurinan Nandagopan in the first Pasuram. And in the 17th Pasuram, she said Ambarame Tannire Sore Aram Seyum Nandagopan. And here she gives another adjective to Nandagopa when she says, Undhu madagalitran odada tholvaliyan Nandagopalan. It seems Nandagopa was in charge of two elephants, big elephants, who would not listen to anybody but him. Undhu madha kaLiTRan, she says. Madha kaLiru refers to literally mad elephants. Sometimes when elephants are supposed to have madha, then they don't listen to anybody except for their master. So, Nandagopa too had elephants like that with him. Which elephants did Nandagopa have? Here actually, Andal is talking about Krishna and Balarama, who were elephant-like. They were so powerful and they were actually the leaders of the universe. So, they were not controllable by anybody. But they would listen to their father Nandagopa because they wanted to show the world that however powerful a son may be, he should be obedient to his parents. So, Nandagopa was the controller of these elephants. Undhu madha kaLiTRan, odatha tholvaliyan. Also, Nandagopa was the one who would never back out from battle. Odatha tholvaliyan, she says. If there was a battle happening, he would never return from the battle because of fear. He would always stand up and fight. And thus, he was always wielding his spear ready to ward off any evil against Krishna. So, every time Andal wants to remind us that Nandagopa was so fond of Krishna that he turned protective about him every now and then. Now, all this is called Pungum Parivu or the overflowing affection towards the Lord. The Lord is the protector of the universe. But devotees like Nandagopa forget that he is the protector of the universe and think that it is their duty to protect the Lord because he has been assigned the role of his father by the Lord. So, how well Nandagopa played that role and how much he loved the Lord is depicted through this. And because of this love of Nandagopa for the Lord, Lakshmi Devi liked to be called as Nandagopa's daughter-in-law. So, she says, Nandagopalan marumagalena pinnai. Andal calls out to Nappinai in the way she likes best. And then she says, you are so fragrant. Gandham kamalum kulali. It seems Nappinai's hair had a fragrance of its own, which was known miles apart. It was a mixture of the fragrance of flowers and tulasi. And that was unique only to herself. Andal and her friends are able to smell this wonderful fragrance and they are almost intoxicated by that. And so, they cannot help mentioning about that. They say, we are able to smell you now. Let us see you also. kaLiTRavai. Please open the door, they say. It's morning time. You should not be sleeping now. It's time to wake up and help us. Let us tell you how much morning it has become. Let us tell you an indication about the morning. She says, Bandhu yengum koli alaithanakaan. Please come out and see. The hens and cocks are all crowing now. Koli alaithanakaan, she said. She's saying come and see. She's not saying here. Because as one of the friends of Andal had said before, even Nappinai would think that probably these girls are making a noise like the birds. So Andal is ensuring that she doesn't mistake them. So she's telling her to come out and see. She's telling Nappinai to come out and see. Kaan, she says. Not only that, we are not talking about just the cocks and hens crowing on the street, but you please come out into your own garden and see. You see in that beautiful jasmine creeper of yours. It seems in Nappinai's garden, there's a wonderful jasmine creeper yard or mandapam, as they say. Creepers need some support to grow on. So it seems Nappinai had erected 4 pillars and had made a mandap kind of a thing for her jasmine creeper to grow. And this mandap she had named as Madhavi mandap. So Andal is saying, come out and see in your Madhavi mandapam. There are beautiful birds shouting out that it is morning. They are all crowing that it's morning. Madhavi pandal mel palkal kuilinangal kuvinakan. Cuckoo birds are crowing out saying that it is morning. Listen to their beautiful voice and come out and see how beautiful they are looking on the Madhavi mandapam that you have made. Now here, Andal specifically uses the word Madhavi Mandapam with a hidden meaning. Andal is from Srivilliputtur, and it seems that Periyarvar, Andal's father, used to often take her to a nearby pilgrimage center called Thirumalirinjolai. And this Thirumalirinjolai, which is somewhere near the current day's Madurai, is famous for an Utsavam called Nupura Gangai Utsavam. So this Nupura Gangai Utsavam happens in a place called Madhavi Mandapam. So remembering that Utsavam of the Lord, Andal refers to Nappinai's Gardens Mandapam as Madhavi Mandapam. Andal is leaving a signature of hers that she belongs to Srivilliputtur by using the term Madhavi Mandapam. So that is showing out that how specifically Andal has observed the details of all Utsavams that Periyalvar has taken her for. So she is mentioning to Nappinai that please come and see that the cuckoos are crowing out in this Madhavi Mandapam of yours. So you need to come out now and help us. But Nappinai doesn't want to walk out. She's talking from inside and saying that all that is fine, but why are you all coming at such an odd hour and trying to take me out from my house and ask for what? What is the purpose of your visit? I'll come out only if you tell me the purpose. Then the girls say, see, we cannot explain our purpose to you when you're sitting inside. You really need to come out. And as they are saying this, they are peeping into the window, it seems. These girls have all the liberty with Krishna and Nappinai. So they are actually peeping into the window and they get to see a beautiful sight. They see that Nappinai Devi is having a ball in her hand and she's sitting beside Krishna. Now the ball in her hand is a significance of something very important. Pandar Virali, they say. Pandar Virali means the one having ball in hand, ball in her fingers. Now why is Nappinai having this ball in her fingers? This is because it seems Krishna and Nappinai were playing a game. And this game was something like passing the parcel. They were passing the ball amongst themselves. And at one point of time, one of them was ending up having the ball. It was decided that the one having the ball in the end would be declared as winner. And what was the prize? The prize was they could do anything with the ball that they had in hand. Now what we need to understand is this ball that Nappinai and Krishna were playing with is nothing but this samsara, this world. And it contains all of us souls, jivatmas inside it. And as this ball is being passed between the two, we are being shuttled between the two. We are undergoing many things inside this samsara. And finally now, Nappinai has the ball in hand, which means that she has won. So Nappinai can do anything with this ball that she wants now. Now, if Nappinai has the ball, what would she do? And if Krishna had the ball, what would he do? If Krishna had the ball, then he would take a call to punish the wrong ones and reward the good ones. Because that is how he has laid down the Shastras. He has said that if you do good deeds, you reap rewards for that. If you do bad deeds or sins, then you suffer for that. So Krishna would decide that people in this ball would undergo suffering as a result of sins and would undergo reward as a result of good deeds. Now, would this be useful to us? As we had mentioned in the fifth Pasuram, elders say that we are all Aparadha Chakravarti. We are all emperors and empresses of committing sins. We are capable of doing wrong very easily. So if the Lord decides to punish for our every wrong, then it will become very difficult for us. So that would be our state if the Lord has the ball in hand in the end. On the other hand, if Nappinai is going to have the ball and have the authority to decide what to do with the ball, then she would tell the Lord on our behalf that though you have laid down in the Shastras that You have to punish sins. You always have the liberty to forgive them if they seek your asylum. So you give them the good thought to seek asylum in you and thus save them from this punishment. So Nappinai would talk on our behalf to the Lord and find a path for us to reduce our suffering or even completely erase it. So Nappinai can pave way for that by speaking to the Lord on our behalf. And this is precisely why she is called Purushakara Bhutai, the one who speaks on our behalf. So now the ball is in the hands of Nappinai. She has become Pandar Virali. That means that we are all going to be saved. The path for us being saved has been paved. And so these girls are all delighted that Nappinai has won the game. Because Nappinai winning the game means we have won the game. So very happily they say, Pandar Virali un maithunan per paada. We are all here to sing the victory that you have achieved over your concert. So you also need to come out and join us in this victory party of yours. Please come out and open the door. Senda marai kayyal seerar valayolippa. Please come and open the doors such that we can hear the jingling sound of your bangles. Seerar valayolippa. And open the door with your wonderful lotus-like hands. Senthamarai kayyal, they say. Now, Nappinai's hands are called as Senthamarai kai. The hands which are like the special lotus, Senthamarai. Whenever we refer to the Lord's hands, we refer to it as Thamarai kai or lotus hands. So the Lord's hands are just lotus hands, Thamarai kai. Whereas the consort of the Lord has hands like the special lotus, Senthamarai. Why is this difference made? It seems that the Lord's hands grant us asylum or abhaya from everything in this world. From every danger in this world, the Lord can protect us. And that is why he is showing his abhaya mudra or asylum sign in his hand. So his hands are called as Thamarai kai or lotus hands. But we have some kind of danger even from the Lord, because he says that he will punish us for our sins. So we are all making mistakes, so we need to be scared of him. So who will save us from him? She will save us from him. Who? Lakshmi Devi, Nappinai Devi, the Lord's consort, by becoming Purushakara Bhutai. And so her hands grant us asylum even from this little fear of the Lord that we have. So they are called as Senthamarai kai, the hands which are like the special lotus. So please come and open the door with those special lotus-like hands. Senthamarai kaiyal seerar valayolippa bandhu thiravai. Please come and open the door. Magrinde lorembavai. That is what will give you, us and everybody happiness. Magindelo rembavai, they say. This particular pasuram has an interesting anecdote connected to it. It seems that Swami Ramanuja, who was the great Visishtadvaitic philosopher and Acharya, was known as ThiruppAvai Jiyar because he was so fond of the ThiruppAvai that he would always keep reciting it. And he would unfailingly recite it when he went to seek alms. We saw in the 14th pasuram that saints used to take bhiksha by seeking alms. Like they did not cook their own food, but they partook food which was piously prepared by suitable people. And so while thus seeking alms, Swami Ramanuja used to recite the ThiruppAvai. And once when he was reciting this particular pasuram, Sendamarai kayyal seerar valayolippa vandhu thiravai magindelor embavai, when he said this phrase, he happened to reach the house of the daughter of his acharya known as Atturai. Atturai was Periyanambi's daughter. Periyanambi was Swami Ramanuja's guru or acharya. Swami Ramanuja was so absorbed in the ThiruppAvai that when Atturai came and opened the door as he sang the Svasuram, he actually thought it was Andal herself or Nappinai herself who came and opened the door. And he actually went ahead to bow down to her thinking that she was goddess herself. Thus was Swami Ramanuja's Bhavana Prakarshan. And so he was called as a ThiruppAvai Jiyar. This anecdote is often quoted whenever this 18th Pasuram is explained. So thinking of that devotion of Swami Ramanuja and the dedication of Andal to Nappinai, let us wait along with these girls to see what Nappinai is replying tomorrow.